Hi, my name is Robbie Phillips. This is a video of my latest rock climbing adventure. I had a dream to free one of the hardest alpine rock climbs in Europe, Bellavista. This route was first put up by Alex Huber back in 2001. At the time, the hardest alpine route in the world. I quote Alex, "A true challenge to free climb that immense overhang. I chose the most difficult option to join a large mountain face with free climbing up to 8C. All of this with a few bolts at the belays on a cold face, as is the north face of Cima Ovest." Earlier this year, I contacted a good friend for many years, Logan Barber. Logan lives in Australia and I had already planned a trip there for the spring. He was as psyched as me on the potential to free such an amazing route together. And so the seed was planted, and before long, we were meeting up for a second time in 2014. This time to do battle with Bellavista.
It is wet on our first day in the Dolomites, so we are going to the bakery.
You don't know?
Yummy. Still raining in Cortina. Just wandering around, looking at stuff. I think we're gonna head off to Innsbruck now, check out Zillertal, do a bit of climbing, sport climbing there. Should be alright. Maybe try Total Brutal, 8B plus, sport route that I've wanted to do since I was like 14, so pretty psyched for that. And then we'll come back when the conditions are better and get on Bellavista.
And so we moved to Zillertal, where we officially started the climbing trip. Unfortunately, luck was not on our side. The European Alps had suffered the worst weather in 30 years. Many pro climbers who said they had plans to climb on the Cima Ovest that year never even bothered showing up, and we found ourselves pretty much alone on the face the whole time. Zillertal wasn't much better off. That place gets even more rain in Scotland, but we made do and got to climb a few awesome sport climbs that I've dreamt about since I was a wee boy. Zillertal turned out to be more than I could possibly hope for in a climbing venue. It was granite sport climbing in a beautiful valley hidden between the mountains. The routes varied a lot in style, but relied heavily on your ability to compress, much like on a boulder problem.
Finally arrived at the Tre Cima. Excited now. everything that we've been hoping to come and do on the climbing trip is finally about to begin. Just setting up now at the base of the Tre Cima, and we're going to start walking pretty soon to the Cima Ovest. There's Logan, setting up all our gear. Hi Logan.
How you doing? It's cold.
It is very cold.
Beautiful morning.
It is beautiful though.
It's going to be a good day.
I think so. Weather last night was, on the journey here, was actually rubbish, but then as we approached the Dolomites, the weather got a bit better, and this morning it's just absolutely beautiful. Very cold, but dry, which is the good thing.
I need to do my hair.
You need to do your hair? You're a real celebrity. Real film star.
Yeah.
What do you think of the Tre Cima?
That's awesome. Yeah,
it looks fantastic, doesn't it?
It's great conditions now. Thunderstorms this afternoon, so hopefully we get up there and off before they hit.
I actually cannot believe how awesome this place is. It's so stunning, and the conditions right now are just so good. And we're going on this! I think it's that. I can't really see. Yeah, that. Oh my god!
I can't believe that Robbie ate all the lollies and the chocolate that was meant to be for today and doesn't have a daisy chain or a belay plate.
Well, I might be the worst alpine climber in the history of planet Earth, but oh well. I don't care. I'm not hungry anymore. I'm a fat boy. I need my Haribo. That's a long way up. Let's go. Hey, we are at the end of the first pitch of Bellavista.
We're on the way down.
We're on the way down now. We're just abseiling down.
We just tried the roof. It was very
wet.
But, yeah, now we're probably going to have a go at the first pitch again.
Yeah, because
it was quite scary.
Leading it was terrifying.
Yeah, I was gripped the entire way. The first piece of gear is just up here.
Just this?
It's this pin.
You see it?
Just in here.
Just in there? Somewhere over there.
And, I don't know, I reckon that's almost 10 metres off the ground.
I think so. About that.
It was quite scary.
Quite a long way down there, I wouldn't want to fall off this bit.
All on loose holds. It was easy climbing, but very, very scary.
Yeah. So we're going to practice it a bit, and just make sure we know exactly what we're doing, so there aren't any mishaps.
That's right.
And I want to see if there's any more gear, but I don't think there is.
There's nothing.
There is nothing. Okay.
Let's get out of here.
Let's go. Catch us later. So what do you think was the hardest part about today's climbing?
For the hardest bit for me was following the 7A, 7A plus with being really wet and slimy and my feet kept popping and I had to just almost camper spits.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was a scary lead. I think the hardest part was watching you solo the first 10 metres. On sight, I think that was the hardest part for me.
And that's when I was the most focused, I think.
Yeah.
So after today, what do you rate your chances? Is it a positive day or...?
Yeah, I think so. It's quite a strange one, actually. I think I rate my chances quite high, actually. It sounds really arrogant, but I don't know, the start of the 8C pitch felt not too bad.
Mm-hmm.
And I'd heard that there's a crux at the start, which we got through, although we didn't climb it clean, you know, sort of figured out the moves essentially, and
although it was just, the conditions were so rubbish, it was just really wet, so...
And that'll be the crux of the whole route, getting good conditions.
Yeah, exactly. I think if we get the moves sorted, and we get day of good conditions, I think we could definitely do the whole thing. I'm pretty confident. And that's after day one. and hopefully if we get more days that are just, you know, good, then we'll have a chance at doing it. What else?
So what do you think of your first sort of semi-alpine multi-pitch experience?
Wild. Pretty out there. I think it's completely different to doing sport climbing or... Yeah, it's just completely different. It's a different sport altogether. It's a different thing. Especially, like, climbing the easier pitches on Bellavista. They're just, you know, 6A, 7A climbing. And you just are so careful with every move. You just don't want to put too much weight on the wrong foothold and it to break off, or to put too much weight on the wrong handhold, or your hands just to slip off because of the wet, greasy nature of the rock. And when it's bad conditions. Yeah, it's just a really different game altogether. I think, I love it. It's definitely exciting. It's just something different altogether, I would say.
Bellavista, made it to the crux pitch. The roof's really slimy and wet, but it's pretty awesome. Yeah.
And Logan's a silhouette.
And I'm a silhouette. And it's raining.
Whoa! That's a long way down, and I almost just dropped the camera. Hanging out quite high up. Just been on Bellavista crux pitch. Today's the second day on it, or the second day on the whole route. Technically the first time I've been to the top of the Bellavista crux. Seems like it's really good. Reckon I can do it. Pretty chuffed that doesn't feel too desperate. Main factors that are affecting performance right now are fear. It is just quite scary when most of the protection's rusty pegs. But I think that come the day that I feel like it'll go, I'll just have to man up and go for it. And hopefully I'll send it. We'll see.
Back in Zillertal, we do a heap of sport climbing with a couple of 8B pluses in tank for me and an 80 plus project, whilst Logan finds a hideous looking crack project up the valley called Ganja. Given 80 plus in the guidebook, I am skeptical about my ability to get up a crack as hard as this, but I'm psyched anyway to give it a go. Ganja is an 8 meter long pure finger crack. My initial attempts were spent learning how to jam and move on the wall, as I'd never done anything like this before. My main issues are pain tolerance and a filthy ring finger mono jam right at the start, which is both bad feet and is followed by a terrible flared back three finger jam that just never feels solid. I am literally in terror of losing my ring finger in this crack.
I hurt myself today to see if I still feel. I focus on the pain, the only thing that's real. The needle tears a hole, the old familiar sting. Try to kill.
First day back on Bellavista after a rest, Logan and I have decided to attempt a ground up free ascent. I haven't cleaned the crux pitch in one yet, but I'm confident that after having done the first 5 pitches clean, with that added pressure of a full free ascent on the line, I will be able to push through and free the crux pitch as well. I warm up on the first pitch, the most dangerous of all of them because there is serious groundfall potential. When we reach the 7A and 7A plus pitches, they are soaking wet and in pretty bad condition. This is a bad omen for the crux pitch, but I'm determined to see it through regardless.
I'm just gonna go chip some holes on Bellavista. Yeah.
So how you feeling, Robbie?
Psyched. Definitely pretty excited about this.
Today's the day. We've done the first 5 pitches in 2 pitches. We had a couple of a fall each. But yeah, you've gone and repeated your one. So you're still on the free ascent.
Yeah.
And how do you think this is going to feel?
Not sure, seeing as that last pitch was soaking wet pretty much. So that means that this one's probably going to feel kind of similar. So I'm just going to give it a mile. Try and just get through it. I think because the pressure's on now, I think I'll try extra hard. And if it goes, it goes. And if it doesn't, then try another time, I guess. But I hope we can make it through this time. I really do. And that'd be an awesome thing to have achieved.
About an hour, a lot of pump, a lot of screaming, and a lot of skin loss later, I arrive at the chains of the Crux pitch. There was a few close calls due to wet handholds and in particular wet footholds, but I refused to die and fought on to the bitter end. I skipped a lot of gear at the end and took a mega run out, but in my mind the worst thing that would have happened would have been a 20 meter fall. It would have been quite fun actually, maybe next time. Logan follows and we celebrate quickly before I free the following 8A pitch, then a bit of a disaster strikes.
Just had an absolute epic. After sending the 8C pitch, I then did the 8A pitch clean as well, which meant that I was on for a full free ascent of the route. And then the 7A pitch, which we'd never actually tried after the 8A, we went the wrong way. And we were there for at least an hour trying to figure out where to go. And it was an absolute nightmare. And I was actually convinced that it wasn't going to go because I thought that I had to do some sort of 20 meter run out into nowhere. And the rock was absolute rubbish. And I was flailing a bit. And I took a 10 meter run out at one point, but it was just, oh man, it was the worst rock ever. And then we actually discovered the right way to go, and I led it, and I'm up here now at the belay, bloody happy that we've made this pitch now, because it's been a bit of an epic. And now Logan is just drugging up, so we'll see him soon. But look, we've still got that to go. We're probably going to get benighted. But we've done all that.
So we've made it to the bivvy. Bit of a forced bivvy. We've got about 10 pitches to go that shouldn't be too hard in the morning. Robbie is on the send train.
Hello.
How was it today, Robbie?
It was good. Now I'm tired and I want to go back to my tent and eat normal food rather than chocolate, which we don't have much of anyway. I'm hungry. And that's a thunderstorm about to hit us. I hope it doesn't hit the wall. Otherwise we're going to get pretty wet. It will suck.
So, the 8C's been done.
It has been done.
And we got a bit lost afterwards, which took a lot of time. The 7A
was
a bit weird, went the wrong way.
Yeah, that was a bit silly.
But
we thought Alexander was just being a bit of a dick.
Alrighty. How you doing, Robbie?
Cold.
What's the time?
3 a.m. I think.
We've got about 2 hours to go. Having trouble feeling our feet.
Yeah.
Very uncomfortable, cold night.
I think this is the most uncomfortable I've ever been in my entire life. I can probably say that with complete confidence, in fact. I've been sitting on a ledge, well, trying to sleep on a ledge, which has been unsuccessful since since when did we arrive?
Probably about 7 actually.
7. Yeah. There you are.
Hello.
And
I think we're going to get up in a couple of hours as soon as the sunlight hits us, or as soon as daylight starts anyway, and start climbing again and get out of this place. The weather was pretty bad last night, or a few hours ago, but it seems to have stopped now.
So, lots of lightning, but yeah, we didn't get struck.
Loads of lightning. That was pretty mental. It's pretty loud, pretty nearby.
Yeah.
Lots of rain, but we were lucky we didn't get affected by that. We didn't get wet.
After an epic on Bellavista, we returned to the ground via waterfalls, wet, freezing, cold, chaussy, and run-out pitches. And finally, a lot of abseiling. Climbing this route was the greatest experience of my life to date, and doing it with my friend and climbing partner Logan Barber was unbeatable. We made a great team, and I hope we can get together for some more alpine adventures again soon. I have some big goals. Our plan was to hit the Eiger in an attempt to free climb the immense Paciencia, an 8A on the north face. Unfortunately, the conditions were suicidal up there, and we opted out and instead travelled north to Germany and some limestone pocket pooling in the Frankenjura. Here we spent the remainder of our trip. And with that, I will leave you. Hope you have enjoyed hearing about our adventures in Europe this summer, and please enjoy some of the footage from the Frankenjura.
We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created.
It's 8A plow.
Say hello.
Hello.
Will make me able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. I have a dream. One day.